One thing I like to do when I teach any high-level programming language is to point out useful distinctions between different concepts, approaches, and programming constructs which tend to appear in programs. In this lesson and the next, I'm going to talk about two different kinds of logic that I observe in my programs. It is not necessarily the case that these two kinds of logic use different programming constructs. Instead, the distinction here is more about what kind of problems they solve. Now, I will use this word logic quite a bit, which is a shorthand way of talking about logical instructions, which can refer to a single line of code, a method, a class, etc. For now though, just think in things between the scale of a single line of code to the size of a method. The first kind of logic that I wish to discuss is what I like to call computation logic. Computation logic concerns itself with solving problems that have to do with the data in the application. Unless it is intermixed with the other kinds of logic, which I will discuss in the next lesson, computation logic can be readily represented in mathematical or algorithmic form. It follows that this makes computation logic not concerned about the broader details of the flow of any particular application, outside of calling methods related to crunching numbers, manipulating strings, or locating a value in a massive array. One of the interesting characteristics of computational logic is that it is very often interchangeable across different programs. This is especially true when the problems you are working with can be solved using only primitive types and reference types which come from the Java standard library. Now, you may have heard this term library before and wondered what it meant. In simple terms, a library is essentially some source file or set of source files which you can use in other programs, such as your own. Normally, these are things which have been written by other developers, but you can make and use your own libraries if need be. Every version of Java has what is called a standard library, which contains all kinds of different sources which can be used for building all kinds of different programs. For example, the classes I use to read and write the game data for my Sudoku application come from the java.io set of libraries from within the standard library, commonly referred to as the jstdlib. There are two important takeaways from this lesson, one of which will become obvious after you finish part 5 of this course, the other of which you can understand immediately. Very often, when you have a problem which needs to be solved with some form of computational logic, someone has already solved that problem. Now, I am not saying that you should always use other people's solutions, as you can learn an incredible number of things by solving problems yourself. In fact, the older and better I get as a developer, the more I tend to prefer my own solutions. However, many of you who wind up working as developers in startups and small companies will have to get comfortable learning and implementing new libraries quickly. The second takeaway is this. Almost invariably, you will benefit from separating code which has different kinds of goals or concerns into different methods, classes, or packages of your application. I will revisit this idea in detail in part 5, as it is the essence of understanding good software architecture. For now, just take my word for it. Here's a coding exercise to help you avoid reinventing the wheel. In the project source code for this lesson, you will find a Java class called Coding Exercise Starter. In this starter, you will find a string variable s which has the following sentence in it: "To refrain from imitation is the best revenge." You will also find a string variable answer which you will attempt to make s equal to. The code below the answer will tell you if you have succeeded or not, and you can verify by running the example. Before you proceed, listen carefully. To complete this lesson, you may not create any new reference variables. You may not directly reassign s to a new string. That would be a big fat fail. Your solution must compile, execute, and pass the equals test. You are encouraged to consult the documentation via your IDE or by visiting the Oracle documentation on the String class in the standard library. Good luck.